Thank you. quite right, Mrs. Connie. We must get rid of this canker in our midst. That boy was born to be young, Mrs. Connie. I have never been so shocked in all my days.
Oh, hush, Mr. Bumble. You must have had quite a turn. Sit down and have a nice cup of tea.
Oh, it's nice to be appreciated, Mrs. Connie. These here paupers in this here parish don't appreciate me. Anti-parochial they are, Mum. Anti-parochial. Why, we have given away a matter of 20 loaves and a cheese and a half this very blessed afternoon, and still them paupers is not contented.
Of course they're not. When would they be? Sweet Mr. Bumble.
Very sweet indeed, Mum. Do you still have a cat, Mum?
Mm-hmm.
And kittens too?
Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm so fond of them. You can't imagine, Mr. Bumble. And they're fond of their own, too.
Oh, Mrs. Bonnie, Mum. I must say that any cat or kitten that could live with you, Mum, and not be fond of its home, must be an idiot and don't deserve to live in it.
Oh, Mr. Bumble.
No, there's no use disguising facts, Mum. An idiot? Why, I would drown it myself. Pleasure.
Then you're a cruel man. And there you are, aren't a man at all.
Oh, no, Mrs. Connie. Hard-hearted. Are you hard-hearted, Mrs. Connie?
Dear me, what a very curious question coming from a single man. What can you want to know for?
Did I nearly catch you smiling? Yes, I did, and it's beguiling. If your hand is close, I'll press it. Yes, you like it, come confess it. Yes, you do.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do.
Yeah, she's got-
good. Then it is settled. £5, please.
If you don't mind, Mr. Bundle. A cash upon liking. And Mrs. Sowerberry!
What is that?
Oh, will you have the goodness to come here a moment, my dear?
What is that? Well, what do you want?
My dear, I've told Mr. Bundle.
Oh, hello, Mr. Bundle.
Hello, Mrs. Sowerberry.
That we may consider taking this boy to help in the shop.
Oh, dear me. He's very small.
Yes, he is rather small, but he'll grow, Mrs. Sowerberry, he'll grow.
Oh, I dare say he will in our kitchens and our drinks. They're a waste of time, these workhouse boys. They always cost more to keep than they're worth. Still, you men seem to think you know what's best. What are you going to do with him?
There's an expression of melancholy on his face, my dear, which is rather interesting. He could make a delightful young coffin follower.
A what?
Oh, I don't mean a regular coffin follower, to follow the grown-ups, but one only for the children's practice. It would be nice to have a follower in proportion, my sweet. A rather nice effect, the more I think about it.
Oh, just once, you might have had a decent idea. Very well then, boy. What's your name?
Arthur Chessman.
Oh.
Hi, Marvin. What a fire and choosing.
Where's Mr. Bumble?
Hi, Mrs. Sowerberry.
How's that, Mr. Bumble?
Oh, the boy's mother came to us destitute. Bring the child into the world, takes one look at him, and probably dies without leaving as much as a quality, name, or address.
Oh, dear, dear. Well, now, Oliver Twist, do you think you could look like that gentleman up there?
Never mind about black hats.
That old boy's quite right, Henry. Give him a hat. These things must be done proper and correct. Now then, Oliver, stand there next to the picture. Henry, just give me a hat. Really? Takes you twice as long to do anything as anybody else. Oh, yes. For once, you had a decent idea. Now then, Oliver, expression with a large crowd watching you.
Yes, I think so.
If someone had their tea cast mute, I can see him in a black suit, following behind a funeral procession with his features fixed in a suitable expression. Maybe horses with all black
Thoughts
macabre, there's no need to frown.
This is the new boy, Oliver Twist. Give it to him! Have you done?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, very well then. Henry! Get to bed! There, Charlotte! Stop standing there, gawking girl! Now then, Oliver Twist, you don't mind sleeping among the coffins, do you? Well, it don't matter whether you do or you don't. And you can't sleep nowhere else.
His mother left him alone. They all left him alone. Except dear old kind old Noah, eh, Charlotte?
You are one.
Workhouse, how's your mother?
You need my mother, Albert. She's dead.
And why she died of workouts. Shortage of bread.
No, you might.
Oh, but I do mind.
Well, you better think you might, see?
Better not. If you don't mind, the cheek of it. A workout's cheek of it. My mother, he says. She was a nice one, she was. You know, workouts can't be helped now, and of course it could be a thing. And I'm sorry and all that, but you must know your mother was a regular right down batter.
What did you say?
A regular right down batter. It's a good thing she died when she did. Else she'd be doing hard labour in prison as like as not. Help! Help! Father! Listen! Help! He's murdering me!
Mm-hmm.
What's the difference now, pork sausage? You're coming with me.
I shall, Mr. Bacon, want mine.
Mine?
Yeah.
Shut up and drink your gin. Ah, I see you're stealing pocket handkerchiefs. There's quite a lot of them, ain't there? We just hung them up, ready for the wash. The wash.
There's laundry then, sir?
Well, not exactly, my dear. Although a laundry would be a very nice thing indeed. But our line of business pays a little bit extra, don't it, boys?
Yeah.
See ya. In this life, one thing comes in the bank, a large amount. I'm afraid these don't grow on trees. You've got to pick a pocket or two. Got to pick a pocket or two, boys. You got to pick a pocket or two. Now, can you see, is my handkerchief protruding from my pocket?
Yes, sir.
See if you can take it out without my noticing, like you saw the others do. On credit, you've got a home and a profession. Now, bedtime, all of you. There's a hard day's work to get paid for all. You can sleep down here, Oliver. Doctor, take your hat off in bed. Have a night, Oliver. I'm afraid the witch was in the sleep. I'm a real miser, ain't I? What can I help you with? It's my little pleasure. A cup of coffee. And a quick counter. I mean, who's going to look after me in the old age? Will you? Will you? You! What are you going to make? What did you see? Quick, quick! Tell me every detail you saw!
I can't sleep anymore, sir! I'm sorry if I disturbed you, sir!
Were you awake 5 minutes ago?
No, sir!
2 minutes ago?
I'm not sure, sir!
Be sure, be sure!
Fine, then, I'm sure!
All right, then. You're sure, I'm sure. Of course, I knew all along, my dear. I was only trying to frighten you. You're a brave boy, Oliver. A brave boy. Tell me. Did you see any of the pretty things, my dear?
Yes, sir.
Ah, they're mine, Oliver. All mine. All I've got to look after me in the old age. It's a terrible thing, old age.
Do you think I could get up now, sir?
Why, certainly. There's a basin of water near the fire. You can have a wash.
I washed yesterday, sir.
Well, today's your birthday. Have a wash. Wake up, boys! The ladies are here!
Oh, I'm letting Thank you.
There's a hard day's work to be done, and there's rich pickings out there in the street. Get out and earn your keep.
Tell all you lot.
Dodger. Take Oliver with you. Oliver, you have to start somewhere, my dear. And you couldn't make a finer start. Good luck on your first job, my dear. I'll be waiting for you when you come back.
If you go back soon, if you go back by your mom, next you'll be safe around until you're home, safe and sound.